bullies and mean girls can like spot a pick me from a mile away. And a pick me is someone with low self-esteem. The when you stand for nothing, you will fall for anything.
Y'all ain't finna clown off me. Y'all ain't finna take me for no joke.
This is Dee. Welcome back to my channel. And if you are new to this channel, welcome. Well, guys, I'm back. And you know I had to throw my hat in the ring regarding the straight up coonery of a Tiffany Haddish. This is pick me, low self-esteem, no self-esteem, I'm not good enough type behavior. I have never liked this woman. She has always rubbed me the wrong way. And this type of thing is why.
What hurts me the most about the Tiffany Haddish situation is after she did what she did on that runway, the people that worked there, she had an interview with them and she was like, oh no, I hope I get invited again. And they were like,
I had no idea why people were laughing in the middle of her ending. And I was like, did we do something wrong? And then everyone was like, Tiffany, she destroyed. Everyone would laugh.
We did the whole
thing. I walked the whole thing. I'm gonna sit down and sit.
They didn't say, I don't know if I could invite Paris Hilton next time. You see how Paris Hilton or none of the Hiltons will never do that? It really solidifies the creators that kept saying that they did it because they didn't think Tiffany Haddish deserved to be there. They humiliated her so that she never gets invited to a runway again. Like, how dare Tiffany Haddish to be invited in a runway? The lady was like, you're going to get up and make a fool of yourself and show that photographer right now. And the way she was commanding Tiffany Haddish to do it right now, the pressure of it was crazy. These people are never, ever going to tell the producers of that runway, hey, we made Tiffany Haddish do it. Hey, you should invite Tiffany Haddish next time. They're never gonna stick up for her. You're just never gonna see her on a runway ever again. And the internet is chopping her off. And she thinks that this shit is normal. This shit is just hard to watch. This shit is embarrassing.
So I'm going to show you some great TikTok reactions to what occurred. And you guys, please, please, in the comments, please let me know your thoughts on this. And this is a topic that's sort of like near and dear to my heart. Because as a person who has always, like I was a tennis player long before Venus and Serena. The tennis club I belonged to was primarily white. In fact, I was the only one in that space. The only Black person on the tennis team. The only Black person in the club. I was literally the only one. So I was exposed to the Kathy Hiltons of this world at a very early age. Because she is a certain type of woman. She is a certain type of white woman, right? This is the type of white woman who will let you know, oh, I'm not racist. I'm not prejudiced. I don't have a racist bone in my body. And yet.
I'm going to give my $20 take on the Tiffany Haddish runway situation with the Hilton. There are so many different ways that you can take this. First and foremost, a take that I don't think a lot of people are leaning into, but I have seen a couple creators speak on it, is the fact that the Hiltons were born and raised going to these events, right? They know the etiquette, they know the rules, they know what's expected of you. They've been going to fashion shows literally since they were toddlers. And they're in these rooms with these people all the time, and it's nothing new for them. So by them pushing someone like Tiffany, who is literally growing up in foster care, not at fashion shows, her things were in trash bags. That's a huge difference in just education level alone, first of all.
So it just goes to show that, like, you are who you surround yourself with. And we actually see that sometimes, right? So, like, you'll see these kind of, like, old money boarding school type of behaviors. And sometimes you'll see someone, like, leave the nest and adopt a different value set. And then they go back and it just, it's so disappointing. Like, you want to know who's lacking taste and decorum. I think to be born into that social set and dare someone who wasn't to do something that would make everyone laugh at them. It's such a, it's like a moment that you would expect to see in like a teen coming of age comedy from like the Mean Girl. As I said, it's just archetypal high school Mean Girl behavior.
The Hiltons were clearly looking down on her. She would never have done this to Gwyneth Paltrow, right? She would never have come at Gwyneth Paltrow like this, or Demi Moore, or Julia Roberts, or you get the point. She would never have done this to a white woman or a non-black woman, even somebody like J-Lo. She would never come at J-Lo like this.
So everybody's talking about Tiffany Haddish crashing the Monse runway show during New York Fashion Week, and understandably so. But I don't hear nearly enough people talking about the implications this has for the Hiltons and what it says about them. So I'm going to take it upon myself to do it. There is a difference between white people and people who happen to be white. The Hiltons are white people. What do I mean by that? In that moment, the way they were talking, the way Kathy was talking to her specifically, was very demanding, very aggressive, suggests that she doesn't look at Tiffany as an equal. She looks at Tiffany as somebody who's there to provide her with a service, that service being entertainment. Tiffany just sitting down side by side with the Hiltons is not where Kathy thinks she should be, subconsciously, psychologically, because that implies that they are peers and that they are equals. One of the symptoms of a white person, not a person who happens to be white, is that they have a strong response mechanism to being in the room with POC, definitely black people, who are there under the same pretenses, and you're not there to provide them with a service. Even if the service is just to be unnecessarily, aggressively jovial and put them at ease. And as myself, I can speak on my life and say that I've been around both types. I've been around white people and people who happen to be white, and I've been around them across various socioeconomic thresholds. The people who feel the need to be entertained always reveal themselves immediately upon interacting with me, because I don't feel pressured to entertain you. I don't feel pressured to justify why I'm here. Knowing that the odds are not in my favor, I probably have more merit than most of the people in this room to be here. I'm not gonna walk around and wear that on my shoulders, but that's the reality of the world that we live in. And I deal with the world as it is, not as it should be. But those white people never liked me. I've never had a white friend, but I've had friends who have happened to be white. Because the white people who were in the room with me, I made them incredibly uncomfortable. I didn't feel the need to try and disarm them and get them to like me. I don't care if you like me, because like I said, I'm here on merit. I deserve to be here off the strength. Whether I come in here and I do this with everybody in the room, or if I sit here and I just stare and I take in the environment, either way you slice it and dice it, I deserve to be here. So I'm not going to apologize for that by trying to make you feel better about my presence. That interaction at the Monse show just shows that Kathy, I'm gonna single out Kathy because she's the one who did most of the talking. And even though the laughter from her children didn't do them any favors, in my opinion, but I'm going to focus on the person who actually did the talking. That interaction shows me that Kathy does not have, I'm not going to say any Black people, but she doesn't have a significant enough number of Black people in her life that she views as peers and colleagues. Never mind friends, because if she did, she would have never felt comfortable approaching Tiffany Haddish like that in a public place. And Tiffany, unfortunately, is one of those Black people and POCs who feels like they have to justify why they are in the same space. I'm not one of those people. And I guarantee you, if Tiffany was not one of those people, Kathy would not like her. Kathy would be very passive aggressive with her. Kathy would have a lot of microaggressions towards her. And why do I feel comfortable saying that with my whole chest? Because that is what white people, not people who happen to be white, have done to me my whole life.
This is why this struck a chord with me about bullies and how women of certain socioeconomic status, myself being in those spaces, the only one, I thought about this. I'm like, gosh, did this ever happen to me? And I really thought long and hard, and the answer was no.
Y'all ain't finna clown off me. Y'all ain't finna take me for no joke.
Like, no one ever tried me like this. And I mean, not only as a child, but as an adult in these spaces and, you know, the upper echelon, if you will, spaces, and primarily white spaces. No one has ever tried me like this. And I realize it's the energy.
And I just watched a video and there was a comment on it regarding this that was saying those Hilton women would have never done this to like Beyonce. And there's a reason for this. When you move into a new town, the vultures, they can pick out the newcomer who needs them. And that's what happened here. Tiffany Haddish did not have the self-esteem as you would have seen Beyonce in this moment. Because first of all, the Hilton people would have never even attempted to ask Beyonce to do this because they would have felt by her very presence, her very aura would have let the Hiltons know to never ask Beyonce to do this sort of stunt. So I want you to tap into the energy of Beyonce versus the energy of Tiffany Haddish in this moment and how they victimized Tiffany because she was victimizable. She was a pick-me energy. She was leaning into them for approval. Beyonce would have never leaned into the Hiltons for approval. If anything, they would have leaned into Beyonce for Beyonce's approval. Feel how that feels. Find inside of yourself if that lives inside of you, and if that's why you're picking the wrong friends, the wrong career, the wrong experience, etc. Because that exudes from you. You might have the best hair, the best outfit, the best makeup, all of the things, but this energy that you carry around with you is bigger and louder than you are. And in the moment of Tiffany Haddish being victimized by bullies, she came in with a beautiful outfit. She looked stunning, but her energy preceded all of that. It jumped ahead of all of the beauty and success that she's had because that is who she is inside. She is a victim inside of self. And they picked up on that. And so will everyone around you if you are a victim. And this is what people prey on. This is what, you know, bosses prey on, friends, society preys on. They pick up that like a dog. And the Hiltons picked up on that in Tiffany like a dog. So recognize that in self. Are you walking around in your Beyonce energy, or are you walking around in your victim energy? Because that energy precedes everything that you have going on outside of self.
Again, this really struck a chord with me, and this is an example of, say it with me now, when you don't stand for something, you fall for anything. When you don't have a sense of self, this is the type of thing that happens when they try you. And I don't blame Kathy Hilton. I blame Tiffany grown-ass woman Haddish, because there will always be a Kathy Hilton.
Tiffany Haddish is, what, in her late 30s, early 40s? And if someone looked at me and tried to double dog dare me to do something at my ripe old age, not going to happen.
Her willingness to shuck and jive for them and make a fool out of herself.
This is what I want to know. I have auditioned for so many of your movies that your friends, your family, why do I never get cast?
Here's the thing. Here's what happens. Like, you as always, me and my family always say you're funny. You know, as producers, you know, you hire people and you cast people. You were always funny, but you was just so, you was always on 10. Like, and you was just, sometimes you just be, like, inappropriate. It's like a love scene, and you want to sit on the actor's lap and fart. And it's like, no, Tiffany, it's not for this scene.
That woman needs help. She needs psychological help. She needs therapy. Representation, positive representation for Black women is few and far between. Don't tell me shit about Oprah. We need positive role models. We need good representation. This is why representation matters. I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you did, please like, comment, and subscribe. And until next time, bye.